Kids International School, Form 2, First Term, History, Lesson Number 2, Renowned Kings of Our Country. Purpose of this lesson: administrative organization and activities of Manamamma dynasty, war campaigns and background, foreign policy of King Vijayabahu, dynasty and royal connection of King Parakramabahu. When you are in grade 6, you learn about kings like Devanampiyatissa, Dutugamonu, Vasala and Mahasena. But now from today's lesson, you will learn about some of the country during the later part of the Anuradhapura and Polonnaruwa kingdom. Now let us discuss about the political situation of the country before King Manamamma's rule. King Vasamba was a ruler who belonged to the Lambakaran royal lineage. During most part of the Anuradhapura period, the country was ruled by kings belongs to Lambakaran and Maurya royal lineages. About 50 years before King Manamamma came to power, King Manamamma is a son of King Kasyapa. King Kasyapa ruled the country for 9 years. After the death of King Kasyapa, Prince Manamamma did not get involved for anything and he lived in hiding. Because King Dantavatissa, who ruled the country at that time, had been looking out for Prince Manamamma. Because of that, Prince Manamamma fled to India. In India, Manamamma became friendly with the Pallava king named Narasingha Varman. During that days, Prince Manamamma supported the Pallava king in his battles. Then Pallava king gave Manamamma an army and supported him to come to Sri Lanka to gain power. Prince Manamamma arrived in Sri Lanka and made battle against King Dantavatissa. During the battle between Prince Manamamma and Dantavatissa, the Pallava king in India, who helped Prince Manamamma, fell ill. Therefore, the army came to support Prince Manamamma returned to India. Because of that, the battle between Manamamma and Dantavatissa was stopped halfway, and Manamamma went back to India for his protection. After that, in India, Prince Manamamma had to serve the Pallava king for about 20 years further to get an army for his support to achieve his goal. Again, King Narasingha Varman gave an army to Manamamma and he came to Sri Lanka with the army. Then Prince Manamamma ascended the throne. King Manamamma was able to rule the country for a long time. It's about 35 years. The tradition of inheriting the kingdom was started during this time. After King Manamamma, his children ascended the throne. King Manamamma lasted for about 300 years until the end of the Anuradhapura area. King Sena. King Sena is a son of King Dappula. They belong to Manamamma lineage. King Dappula ruled the country about 16 years. After death of King Dappula, one of his sons named Aggabodhi ruled the country for 3 years. After King Aggabodhi, his brother King Sena ascended the throne in 833 AD. During King Sena's ruling period, the Pandya state in South India was becoming powerful. The Pandya king Sri Maharshi Vallabha invaded this country with a huge army. King Sena's army was defeated. King Sena's brother Prince Mahinda and King Kassapa fought in the battle, but they were killed in the battle. King Sena and his army fled to Malay area for protection. Then the Pandyan armies entered the city of Anuradhapura and plundered the whole city. Later, a peace treaty was drawn up between the Pandya king and King Sena. And subsequently, the rule of the country was once again handed over to King Sena. And the Pandyans returned to India. And then King Sena returned to the capital city to restore the areas that had been destroyed by the invading army. He also put up several new constructions related to Ritigala and temples like Jetavanaramaya and Abhayagiriya. However, after some time, Prince Udaya and Prince Sena died of some diseases. Prince Sena was son of Prince Kashyapa. Prince Kashyapa, who was one of the brothers of King Sena. During Prince Sena's period, the country was politically peaceful. King Sena completed the restoration work of everything that had been destroyed due to enemy invasion that had taken place during the reign of King Sena. There are construction of a hospital in Mihintale, construction of a dam named Manimekala, cross the Mahavali, and construction of a sluice for Minnairiya Vava are some of the examples. During King Sena's period, Pandya Prince Varagunavarman came to Sri Lanka for seeking support to wage battle against the Pandya kingdom. Then King Sena sent an army commanded by his able commander General Kuttuka to invade the Pandya territory. The Lankan army surrounded Madupura, the capital city of Pandya kingdom, and launched an attack. The Pandya king Maharshi Vallabha was killed in the attack that was launched by the Lankan army. The Lankan army returned to the country victoriously. This victory that King Sena achieved has been recorded in several stone inscriptions. It called Kutta Senaviradana was found in Iripinniyava in the Anuradhapura district. Organization of the administration system of the state. Central administration. The king was the head of the central administration. Inheritance of the throne by the son from his father. For an example, after King Pandukabhya, his son Mutasiva inherited the throne. Inheritance of the throne by the younger brother from the elder brother. For an example, after King Dutugemunu, his brother Prince Saddathissa inherited the throne. And kings took care of the education in the country too. Academic studies, which included language, learning, and writing, were done mostly under bhikkhus. As the king was in the highest position of the central administration of the country, he was responsible for performing a number of tasks. Here are the few of responsibilities: maintaining law and order in the country, protecting the country from both internal and external enemy attacks. Appointing officials that are required for the central administration as well as for regional administration. Handling the economic activities of the country and imposing taxes. Managing judicial affairs. King Vijayabahu the Great. King Vijayabahu the Great is one of the great ruler of Sri Lankan history. King Vijayabahu's father was Mahasami Moggallana and his mother was Lokita Devi. King Vijayabahu ruled Sri Lanka for a period of about 40 years. During this period, a united and peaceful Sri Lanka was created once again under the capital city of Polonnaruwa. The first king of the Polonnaruwa was King Vijayabahu. King Vijayabahu married a princess named Tilokasundari of Kalinga. He did lot of services to religion in Sri Lanka. They are obtaining bhikkhus from Burma and restoration of Upasampada, higher ordination in Sri Lanka, establishments of three-story Dalada Mandiraya in Polonnaruwa, renovation of the access road to Sri Pada and offering land to Sri Pada temple, renovation of temples and stupas in Anuradhapura and Ruhuna. King Vijayabahu's foreign policy. He gave his sister Princess Mitta in marriage to a Pandya prince and built up friendly relationship with the Pandya kingdom. And he married a princess named Tilokasundari of Kalinga Desha and became friendly with the Kalinga state. King Parakramabahu the Great. Prince Parakramabahu's father was Manabarana. Prince Parakramabahu's mother was Princess Ratnavali. When Prince Parakramabahu was still a child, his father died. Prince Parakramabahu and his mother went to his stepfather, Kitsirimega. Prince Parakramabahu came to power in Dakshina Desha. While he was ruling Dakshina Desha, he launched a campaign to enhance the economic development of that area. He adopted the motto which said, "Not a single drop of water that falls from the sky should be allowed to flow into the sea without making some use of it by the people." While he was ruling Dakshina Desha, Gajabahu ruled in Polonnaruwa. King Parakramabahu was able to take the tooth relic and the ball relic. Sri Lanka was established in 153 under the rule of King Parakramabahu. Parakrama Samudra in Polonnaruwa is one of the greatest of the irrigation schemes implemented by King Parakramabahu. 163 tanks were constructed during the reign of King Parakramabahu. Podgul Viharaya, Kiri Vihara, Pabalu Vihara are built by King Parakramabahu. King Nishankamalla. King Nishankamalla was the son of king named Jayagopa. His mother was named Queen Parvati. King Nishankamalla was born in the Kalinga state itself in India. He constructed the Dalanda Mandiraya to deposit the sacred tooth relic. Rankotvehera, Vatadagaya and Nishankalata Mandapaya are some of the building constructed done by King Nishankamallava. Summary: rulers of Lambakarna and Maurya dynasties regent most part of the Anuradhapura area. there were conflicts for power between these two dynasties. Manavarma dynasty was an important royal lineage in Sri Lanka. Political stability was attained under King Manavarma. Lanka had been attacked by Pandyas during the rule of King Sena. King Sena invaded the Pandya state. Administrative activities were methodical during the Anuradhapura kingdom. Three South Indian states influenced Lanka. Chola, who captured the north part of Sri Lanka, ruled that area, making Polonnaruwa their capital. King Vijayabahu freed the country from Cholas. A united and prosperous Sri Lanka was created under King Parakramabahu. King Nishankamalla was another great ruler who came to power after